Dear friends, do you know the importance of this day? Today is the 7th Sunday and 50th day after Easter. All churches observe this Sunday as a Pentecost Sunday and considers it as the birthday of the congregation. Long ago, it was on this day of Pentecost the apostles received the Holy Spirit. The traces of observance of this day roots back to the Jewish community who considered the festival of Pentecost as their harvest festival. Further, the festival was observed in remembrance of receiving the Ten Commandments from the Mount of Sinai. In fact, it is a festival of joy and happiness, in addition the time to help the needy and the poor. In Acts chapter 2 verse 1 to 12, we find that when the day of Pentecost came, all the believers were gathered together in one place. Suddenly there was a noise from the sky which sounded like the mighty wind blowing, and they could see tongues of fire which spread out and touched each other present there. They were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to talk in other languages as the Spirit enabled them to speak. Different places gathered there were amazed to hear the believers in their own mother tongue. What happened there was a fulfillment of the promise given by Jesus Christ to the apostles. During the resurrection of Jesus Christ, Jesus gave the Holy Spirit, the Helper and the Counselor, to remain with us until He comes back. The Holy Spirit is omnipotent, the Almighty, and the source of wisdom. Only the person who truly believes in the God can taste the Holy Spirit in their lives. The gift of Holy Spirit to the believers are explained by Saint Paul in 1 Corinthians chapter 12 verse 8 to 10. At the same time, Holy Spirit can act upon our lives by producing the good qualities of life, such as the fruits of the Holy Spirit. Now, let us focus on these fruits. Matthew chapter 7 verse 17 says, "We can judge a tree by its fruits. A good tree bears good fruit, but a poor tree bears bad fruit." In the same way, the person who experiences the Holy Spirit within can produce good fruits, which are love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, faithfulness and gentleness, as given in Galatians chapter 5 verse 12. Now, let's quickly glance at these fruits of the Holy Spirit. Love. Bible says to love your God with all your might as well as to love others. Jesus taught us to love your enemies as well. This can be accomplished when the Holy Spirit resides in you. Joy. Joy is more than just being happy. It's a feeling awakened by possession. Peace. Peace is a serenity that flows from order. God wants us to bring order to our lives. Patience. To endure everything that is inconvenience, difficulties, hardships without complaint. Kindness, extending a helping hand or sympathy to the poor and needy. Gentleness, to be submissive to God and everybody. Faithfulness, to be reliable and trustworthy in everything. Now, it's time to examine ourselves and discover the fruits of the Holy Spirit within us. May the Almighty shower His blessings so that we may produce the good fruits of Holy Spirit as much as we can. So, today's task is to study the fruits of the Holy Spirit by drawing a good tree which produces the fruits of the Holy Spirit.